This video clip presents a new feature that enables faster IFC property management in ARCHICAD 19. One of the great data management features of ARCHICAD 19 is mapping project properties and schedule data in the IFC Scheme Setup dialog to IFC properties for IFC export, fulfilling different documentation standard requirements. ARCHICAD 19 offers a new capability that enables you to create mappings used by multiple GDL objects or object types faster. Let's say that we want to create a new IFC property called Item Cost for all doors in the IFC model we would like to export. When we create a mapping rule for this IFC property at the IFC door level of the IFC hierarchy, we can add object parameters to the rule content. In this example, we add the cost parameter of the door 19 object to the rule content. This will mean that the item cost IFC property will be filled with whatever value we specify for the cost parameter of the door 19 object, and all other GDL objects derived from its subtype. In this case, however, it will also mean that if we specify a value for the cost parameter of another door, its item cost and IFC property will not take that value, since the door object is not based on the door 19 object. This means the mapping rule is not executed for that door object. We would have to define another mapping rule for it to work on that door object as well. Defining one mapping rule is not sufficient for all door objects. We would have to define multiple rules to cover all door subtypes. Let's now consider the same scenario. We add the cost parameter of the door 19 object to the rule content. In the Additional Object Parameters dialog, we find the door 19 object, find the cost parameter in the Available Parameters field, and click it to select it in the list. Now, instead of clicking the Add button, we click the down-pointing arrow portion of the button and select the new Add as Library Part Independent option, then click the OK button to accept these changes. This means that this rule will work on every item that's classified and exported as an IFC door and has this parameter. This includes all other door objects. If we now select any other door object and set its cost parameter, its item cost IFC property will be automatically filled with that value. This way, we've defined a mapping rule that applies to multiple GDL objects, not only the one it's defined for and others based on its subtype. This feature can be taken one step further if we define such mapping rules at higher levels of the IFC hierarchy. Let's now consider the case where we define the item cost IFC property on the IFC element level of the IFC hierarchy instead of the IFC door level as we did so far. The IFC element level includes all building elements, such as walls, slabs, and roofs, all MEP elements, such as ducts and pipes, and all other types of IFC elements, such as furnishing and elevators. If we create a mapping rule for it, and add the same cost parameter of the door 19 object as a library part independent parameter, the mapping rule will now be valid for and executed on every GDL object in our project, provided that the GDL object has a cost parameter. We can see, for example, that an armchair object has this IFC property, and it also has a cost parameter. If we now set a value for its cost parameter, we can see that its item cost IFC property is filled with the value we specified. Thus, the mapping rule works for every GDL object that has the cost parameter. In summary, this new enhancement can save you much time and drastically reduce the number of mapping rules you need to define in your IFC schemes.